My name is Nasha Dayini, or you can call me Nasha, your official tour guide for today. And I am from International College of Yayasan Melaka. In this virtual tour guide, let me take you to Penang, Malaysia. At first, we are going to Penang Hill, followed by other tourist attractions that are interesting. And I hope everyone in the best condition for today. But before we proceed, there are some friendly reminder and safety precaution that I want everyone to know. So our tour will be smooth flowing and hassle-free. Number 1, please don't throw your trash everywhere and might as well put into your bag. Number 2, never leave your thing unattended to avoid unnecessary loss. Number 3, please synchronize your time and my time so that no one will be left behind. And number 4, please wear your mask properly, use hand sanitizer often and kindly follow the SOP given. I have a lanyard with me so everyone could look at me easier. And if anyone from you need a basic medical care, I have here in my first aid kit. So please don't hesitate to call me right away. Are you all excited?
Yes!
I can hear you!
Yes!
Okay, well, me too! Penang Hill was the first colonial hill station developed in Peninsular Malaysia. Penang Hill, also affectionately known as Bukit Bendera by the locals. It is located 6 km away from Georgetown and set about 821 above Penang Capital. Penang Hill was also the best known tourist attraction due to its fresh climate. From here, we will ride the iconic funicular train and the journey will take about 5 to 10 minutes. From the top, you can see a mountain of Langkawi and Notes Kedah. Now, we will go on a nature walk at the Habitat Penang Hill. The Habitat Penang Hill allows visitors to reconnect with nature in its purest form. It offers the most complete and educational Malaysian rainforest experience. Make sure don't miss out the 230-meter Langkawi canopy walk and Curtis Crest Tree Top Walk, where you can soar in mesmerizing 360-degree panoramic view of Penang Island. There are also a few activities you can do at the Habitat Penang Hill. Thus, Penang Hill is home to a rare number of animals and plants, which you may encounter when you explore the area. You will see cheeky dusty leaf monkey, giant black squirrel, flying lemurs, and over 100 types of birds. Now we have arrived at second place named Wonderful Museum. As you can see right here, it is a replica of Ais Kacang. This museum shows Malaysia's unique food culture. Drawn from the nation's rich multiracial diversity, and this museum was set in 1940 colonial building in Georgetown. The museum seeks to educate people by display history of food in Malaysia. They also have heritage food, rare and disappearing dishes such as this glutinous rice cooked in pitcher plants and orang asli dish. This museum divided into 3 galleries called Info Zone, Wow Zone and Educational Zone. All the hyper-realistic models are handcrafted by museum owner Sin Lau Utilities Food Replication Technique from Japan. And currently, it has more than 500 food items on display. The first section have over 100 types of popular street food and delicacies of Malays, Chinese and Indians. all of which are displayed individual in glass cases. Info zone also feature of how the local eat on a typical day. Giant replica food section in the wow zone proved to be a big hit among locals and tourists alike. You can take photo and selfie with the replica, and also you can use the prop given by the museum. There are giant replicas such as cendol, rojak, karimi, ais kacang and laksa. In educational zone, they show to the public how certain dining choices can have negative impact on the environment. As you can see, the wedding table scattered with bloody shark to highlight the inhuman process of producing shark fin soup. They also have local fruit, candy and world most expensive food section. This is fun and creative food wonderland that bring powerful message on how important food trend and eating habit through the display. And while you are in the museum, please do not take any prop provided and keep your trash with you until you found the rubbish bin. Since we are done our tour at Food Museum, I know everyone must be hungry. So let me take you to the one of the famous restaurant in Penang. We are in front of Nasi Kandar Din Maju. The restaurant is one of the best known restaurant in Penang since 3 years ago. It is perhaps one of the best nasi kandar because the price is affordable and much cheaper than other nasi kandar. There are many dishes you can choose such as beef, chicken, fish, squid and many cook in different type of curry. You may start your queue right here and enjoy your food. Our next destination is Dark Mansion. Dark Mansion is first and only glow in the dark museum in Malaysia. This museum consists of creative, trendy, modern artwork that have incorporated with science and technology, which is created the new main attraction. Main attraction of this museum is Fire and Water Tribute to Darwin. This is the only masterpiece that have a day-to-night transition effect and can be only found in this museum. They also have Fairy Tale Land, Tropical Pandora, The Forbidden Land, Infinity Room and New Atlantis, The Underwater World. Each section have their own unique theme. And the most important thing is everything in the museum is glow-in-the-dark and 3D. Take a great picture of your adventure because you can never have experience like this when you are going home. As for now, we are at Penang Street Art located in Georgetown, the most popular attraction in Penang. You must be wondering how they paint on the old building, right? 2012, Penang Municipal Council hired an artist named Ernest Zakharovic to perform his art around the city. Many tourists and locals love taking pictures with the painting. Apart from taking pictures with the painting, you can also shop for souvenir, clothes, and you can enjoy some food that are sell around this street art. Before we begin, I have some reminder to everyone. You can wear sunscreen or a hat to prevent yourself from too much exposure, UV ray and sunburn. Today, we will eat at Union Street Karim Pasembur Rojak. Established in 1945, Karim's little blue pushcart was familiar at the Union Street. Pasembur is a dish with deep fried and boiled ingredients that serve along with vegetable portion of fresh cucumber, turnip and bean sprout. You can choose from a menu with everything from crab stick, fish, squid, crab and hard-boiled egg, and there are many types of fritter too. And topped with a delicious, warm, spicy and sweet potatoes gravy. The price also affordable and the cheapest among others. The ingredients price are from 50 cent onward and expect to pay more depending on the size and types of ingredients. Enjoy your snack before we heading to the next location. From here, we will walk to the next location because it only take around 4 minutes to reach Fort Cornwallis. It is sad to say that this mark will be our last destination for today. As you can see now, we are at the historical place named Fort Cornwallis. Fort Cornwallis is the largest standing fort in Malaysia. Constructed in 18th century by East India Company but never engaged in combat. And it's named after Marquis Charles Cornwallis. Taking a walk around it really isn't much, except a couple of cannons left. A nice view and a small souvenir shop. It gave off a little eerie aura as we took a nice stroll around. However, be advised that it can be a pretty warm inside. I hope everyone enjoyed the tour for today. If you have any clarification or suggestion, just let me know. I would like to thank all of you for choosing me to be part of your unforgettable journey. Hope to see you again in future tour and have a safe trip back home. Again, this is Nasha signing off. Thank you and goodbye.